Many see nanotechnology as the means by which we will save the human race, though others see it as the key to our own undoing. Nanotechnology, as futuristic of an idea it might seem, is not a new one.
It's nanotech, you like it?
Bill Clinton was promoting nanotechnology research as far back as 1999. He raved about how we could use it to do a plethora of amazing things that would advance humanity significantly. But more on that in a bit. What exactly is nanotechnology? Simply put, nanotechnology is essentially machines and materials that are built at an incredibly small level. How small exactly? Well, in order to quantify it, we need to consider the size of a single nanometer, which is where the term nanotechnology comes from. To give some perspective, a single strand of human hair is approximately 100,000 nanometers wide. A lot of viruses are around 300 nanometers wide, and even smaller than that at 100 nanometers wide, you have nanomachines. So as you can see, nanotechnology is incredibly small, even smaller than viruses in some cases. We can now quantify the size of a nanomachine, but you might be thinking, why would we even need to build machines on such a minuscule level? This is Richard Feynman, widely considered to be the father of nanotechnology. In his 1959 lecture, There's Plenty of Room at the Bottom, he states, "At the atomic level, we have new kinds of forces and new kinds of possibilities, new kinds of effects." Our entire world is made up of atoms, the smallest form of matter. Atoms are essentially the building blocks of our reality. When it comes down to it, if one wishes to control the world around them, they need to control it on a fundamental level, which would be on the atomic level. Nanotechnology is nowhere near as small as an atom, which would be around 0.1 nanometers. This logic still applies, however. The smaller the scale of your control, the bigger the impact you can make on the world around you. Once you work on the nano level, you can fundamentally alter the way things work. Did you know, for example, that nanomaterials are used in the very car you drive? They make your car lighter, stronger, and improve fuel efficiency. These same materials are used for the hulls of spacecraft as well. Manipulating these products on the nano level allows us to make drastic improvements upon them. Need another example? Well, what if I told you that the very clothes that you buy have nanomaterials woven right into them? Substances like nanosilver help fend off bacteria that make your clothes smell when you sweat, and nanotitanium dioxide helps protect your clothes from the sun. These are all somewhat mundane examples, however. Creating lighter or more durable material is useful, but how can nanotechnology truly change our lives on a more drastic scale? Nanotechnology could bring an end to climate change. In 2019, MIT engineers constructed a system of nanotechnology that could remove CO2 from the air. Electrical plates lined with nanotubes effectively collect CO2 particles while the rest of the air passes right through them. Once the electricity is discharged, the CO2 is then collected and disposed of. Not only is this process incredibly efficient, but it also consumes very little energy. This doesn't just apply to the air we breathe either. Nanotechnology can also be used to purify the water that we drink through similar methods. The benefits of nanotechnology are not limited to the world around us. It can make a difference to the world inside of us as well. Research is being conducted every day on how nanotechnology can benefit us in the medical field. One of the most common means of treating illness is with medically prescribed drugs. Typically, in order to apply these drugs to our body, we ingest them through our stomach. Well, researchers have actually been looking into different methods of implementing nanotechnology to deliver these drugs instead. With nanotechnology, drugs could be applied directly to where they're needed, which would be much more effective than our current traditional methods. This is just one way that nanotechnology is changing medicine as we know it. Imagine if we implemented these same methods with a disease like cancer. In the modern world of medicine, cancer is treated with surgery and chemotherapy, none of which are 100% reliable. On top of this, these treatments can have side effects that can be harmful to a patient. If we were to apply, say, chemotherapy to a cancer patient with a nanomachine instead, these same chemotherapies can be applied directly where they're needed in the body, instead of on the whole body. Nanotechnology can also be used to determine exactly where the cancer in a patient is located, meaning that doctors can more effectively eradicate it fully. Additionally, with extremely precise tracking of cancer cells, the disease could be found extremely early when there are only a few irregular cells formed by using nanotechnology. With all this in mind, it seems safe to say that the very future of the human race could be in the hands of nanotechnology. Between eradicating climate change, pollution, and disease, nanotechnology could end up saving us as a species. Or it could potentially have the opposite effect. Could nanotechnology prove to be what finally ends the human race and even the entire Earth? It might sound far-fetched, but this concern has been heavily hypothesized since the very conception of nanotechnology. It is assumed that nanobots of the future would be self-replicating and could exponentially replicate to the point that they consume the Earth. This is actually so concerning to some that it has been suggested that we shouldn't create nanobots at all. There's even a name for the theoretical doomsday that would befall mankind if we were to take nanotechnology too far. This theory is referred to as the Grey Goo scenario. This is the scenario that would take place when nanobots are able to reproduce without human involvement to the point where they consume the entire Earth. The most essential phrase to take away here is without human involvement. But do self-replicating nanobots even exist yet? On this channel, you may have seen our video on xenobots. Xenobots are the first ever self-replicating nanobots that were created last November in 2021. So self-replicating nanobots do indeed exist, and the announcement of their creation sent the media into a frenzy, understandably. Luckily, these xenobots are not able to self-replicate indefinitely, but with their creation, we are now one step closer to that reality. You may be wondering, how are these xenobots able to self-replicate? The xenobots created last year are made up of the stem cells of the African clawed frog. In order to self-replicate, they move around and gobble up other stem cells from the frog. They then take these stem cells and reassemble them into another xenobot that, in turn, gobbles up more stem cells and creates more xenobots. So, what would be the next step towards creating a nanobot that could bring about the apocalyptic Grey Goo scenario? Let's say we create a nanobot that replicates like the xenobots, except instead of only consuming and reassembling frog cells, they can do this with any material. Perhaps a few of these machines were created that they knew how to grab materials around them and reassemble them so that they created more self-replicating nanobots. But how would they know how to do this? Some hypothesize that if advanced AI were to be implemented into these machines, they could teach themselves how to continually reproduce using various materials around them. At this point, the nanobots could disassemble the whole Earth and turn everything into a so-called Grey Goo. The Grey Goo scenario was first thought up in 1986 by American engineer Drexler and proposed in his book called Engines of Creation. When he used the term Grey Goo, he wasn't necessarily referring to the color or texture of what would come of the situation. It instead reflects what the world would be like if all of the life on Earth were arranged into a lifeless mass of nanobots. While the scenario certainly sounds terrifying, do we really have anything to worry about? The overarching opinion in the scientific community seems to be that we are so far from anything like this happening technologically that it isn't worth fretting over. Some say that even if this were to happen, we would be able to catch it soon enough to put a stop to it. Then there's Elon Musk. Elon has continually warned the public about the potential threat AI could pose to humanity. At a National Governors Association meeting in 2017, he stated that AI is a fundamental existential risk for human civilization. He believes we should regulate AI proactively instead of reactively, meaning that we shouldn't write it off until it's too late. Elon has even suggested that AI experts often think they know more than they do, and that their lack of concern over AI is scary.
The biggest issue I see with so-called AI experts is that they think they know more than they do. And they think they're smarter than they actually are. This tends to plague smart people. They define themselves by their intelligence, and they don't like the idea that a machine could be way smarter than them, so they discount the idea, which is fundamentally flawed. That's the wishful thinking situation. I'm very close to the cutting edge in AI, and it scares the hell out of me. It's capable of vastly more than almost anyone knows, and the rate of improvement is exponential.
perhaps we should consider the risks of nanotechnology and AI before it becomes a threat to humanity. After all, technological advancements are being made at a rate nobody 100 years ago would have ever thought possible. Perhaps the grey goose scenario isn't as far off as we might think. At the same time, we cannot ignore the improvements that nanotechnology continues to have in our lives. Could nanotechnology save the Earth, or ultimately cause the destruction of the world as we know it? Do you think we should embrace nanotechnology for its incredible benefits, or rid ourselves before it's too late? Or maybe somewhere in between? Let us know in the comments below. If you liked what you've seen and want to see more like it, please give us a like and subscribe to TechNeo. Thanks for watching.